Welcome back, degenerate watch addicts. I'm currently in the process of impatiently waiting for my PRX digital watch to arrive. Laugh all you want, I'm looking forward to this shamelessly fun watch because number one, it's shamelessly fun, and number two, it's an all-metal digital watch, which is an area of the watch community that is criminally underpopulated. So basically, I'm back in the mood for metal digitals and figured I'd add another bullshit watch-related video into the cesspool that is YouTube. I'll make sure to put the model numbers of each of my watches in the video if you're interested in finding them for yourself. The category of metal digital watches, to me, is interchangeable with the category of luxury digital watches, which is an area that's almost destined to fail. The concept of luxury often leaves a bad taste to many because there is no set standard on quality to cost, so more often than not, we're left with overpriced garbage for the sake of hype and flex culture. On the other hand, the concept of digital quartz watches is associated with an unflinching dedication to accuracy, efficiency, and cost-effectiveness. So the idea of luxury and digital quartz combined is almost like an oxymoron of contradicting ideals. With that being said, I have no intention on trying to convince anyone that luxury digital watches are anything other than something I thoroughly enjoy. The main thing I enjoy is the combination of that wonderful sci-fi tech I grew up on wrapped up in a serious material. The childlike wonder I had growing up watching films like Blade Runner, Back to the Future, Star Wars, The Last Starfighter, Enemy Mine, and etc. stems from the same source of enthusiasm that makes me love digital watches. And there's nothing better than seeing that electric display encased in steel, because now it's no longer a toy. Now it's a tool. Plastic is for toys, and metal is for real life. Whether or not that statement is true is irrelevant. That is simply the feeling I get from it. Metal is the bridge between a whimsical fantasy and reality. It transforms something that would otherwise be a temporary thing into something real that can be kept forever and even passed down from generation to generation. This is why metal, paired with digital watches, is so special to me. Also, the sense of longevity I get from metal is immediately apparent. It's stronger, won't deteriorate as quickly, and at the very least appears of higher quality. And even on just a superficial level, the added heft and density that is inherently tied to metal makes me feel like I really have something substantial on my wrist. And I'm telling you, there's no comparison between a plastic digital watch and a metal one. So because I love digital watches so much, it's the material that I feel they deserve to be presented in, at least more frequently than they are now. Unfortunately, steel is apparently some precious metal to digital watch companies like Casio, Seiko, and Citizen, as a steel case often increases the price tag automatically by $500 at a minimum. Hopefully this is a trend that fades away, but it probably won't. Personally, I'm enough of a degenerate that I will pay the ridiculously high premiums just for the steel exterior. That's not to say that I think it's okay. I know for a fact that steel digital watches can be made and sold at a great value price. There's room for a new brand to step in and become the next budget-friendly steel digital watch company, and that at least gives me some hope. Who knows? Maybe after I retire, which is in 6 years, I might spend my free time starting up that company. But that's enough rambling for now. Long story short, metal digital watches are awesome, and they have a permanent residence in my collection. If you agree with me, then you're awesome too. I'm gonna get back to refreshing the tracking status of my next package like a rabid hyena. Stay classy. I sure as hell won't.